Welcome everybody to the 40 Finance Channel. My name's Jeff Beers. Today I'm going to ask the question, should you buy Facebook stock in 2020? Facebook just released their Q4 earnings report and there was a lot of hubbub around it on whether or not it was a good quarter. The stock actually dipped relatively sharply coming out of the report. So let's take a look at the business and see, hey, is this a good investment for 2020 or is there a better time to buy Facebook stock? All right, looking at the chart for Facebook stock right now, the P/E ratio stands at 33.26. This is after a small dip in the price down to $207 per share. You got a forward P/E of 23.81. The 52-week range on this stock goes from 159 to 224. The 159 was way back, you know, basically a year ago. And they had a really good 2019 as far as making some gains in their shareholder value. They experienced somewhat of the same dip that we all saw in the fall, but it wasn't as bad as some of the other companies. And then it peaked as everything else did with the stock market heading into 2020. But after this recent earnings report, people started to poke some holes into Facebook. And what we're going to look at is to try to determine, is this worthy of the stock going down, these news bites that you see around, or is just this a temporary downturn in price? And that makes this a good opportunity for folks to jump into Facebook stock. So on the earnings report, Facebook nailed all the key metrics that you look for in a stock, okay? So revenue was up plus 25% year over year. Earnings per share beat expectations, $2.56 versus $2.53. So they hit that. Their monthly active users actually went up 8% year over year, which that's kind of difficult to do, sort of like Netflix when you have, you know, most of America and a lot of the opportunity that's international, they're starting to cross a lot of those places off. So to get plus 8% on users, it's a pretty strong metric. And average revenue per user, $8.52. The expected was $8.32. So again, they crossed all the check marks in terms of revenue, growth, all the things that were expected out of Facebook stock for Q4. They hit them. So what's the problem? What are people looking at? What are they discussing from an analyst perspective that you see some of this negative press? All right, so the big thing that sticks out in Facebook earnings was the capital expenditures, right? So the cost of doing business, the cost to keep systems up, and it's actually went up in 2019 over 2018. And in some companies, I guess you could say this would be expected because the company gets bigger, so on and so forth. Facebook, though, just can't seem to avoid the high price fines and costs of doing business, okay? So they've had big fines from Europe for privacy concerns. They likely have fines from the United States for the same thing. They have employment costs, and everybody's trying to poke holes and get some money from Facebook. So the capital expenditures actually did go up again in 2019. And while they haven't released the expectation for 2020 yet, the anticipation is that these costs are going to continue to go up as more and more people sort of attack Facebook, both from a privacy standpoint. It's one of those stocks with digital and internet changing the world that the government is really starting to take notice on the Googles and the Facebooks and the Amazons of the world. And frankly, every politician seems to have an angle of how they're going to attack these mega corporations to try to get some money out of them. All right, so what does it all mean for Facebook's price in 2020? When we look at the TipRanks dashboard, we see an unbelievable 28 of the best performing analysts have a buy rating on Facebook, two holds, no sales. The median price estimate as of today is $256, $255.96. That is a 22%, almost 23% upside from where we stand today after the recent dip. You got a high bar of $300 from one analyst, and you have a low bar of $200 from another analyst. So you put it together, and the risk-reward scenario here stands right about 23% as far as America's best analysts are concerned. Now, from my perspective, beyond price targets, I think the most intriguing thing about Facebook is just how much it's grown. When we think about this stock, we obviously think of the big F with the blue circle around it, but there's so much else here. There's so much else here that's growing. I think most people know about Instagram that they own. WhatsApp is another platform that they haven't unlocked any value for yet. There's no advertising on there. They talked about releasing some advertising, and that got a big uproar, so they pulled back. They're preserving a very united user base on WhatsApp right now, and there will be a way to unlock revenue there, and I think what it'll come down to is payments. That's where you get into Calabra, which is their sort of Bitcoin-esque payment system that they want to build within the Facebook network. That faces a ton of regulation, and quite honestly, I don't know if that thing will ever go live, but I do believe that some form of payment in the Facebook platform will absolutely be launched. It would be sort of nice if it was something like Calabra, where you could send money back and forth between countries and whatnot on one common denominator. But even if not, we know there are things like PayPal where you can send money to people in different countries with different currencies. So I would say like the solution is already exists if Calabra doesn't work out. It's just a matter of implementing it into the platform. That will add to capital expenditures, absolutely for sure, but you have to understand how big of a move it would be, particularly for younger generations in developing countries where banks aren't as recognizable and not all folks use them. So if you get into this world where a portion of your paycheck, you know, ends up in Facebook because that's how you send money to friends and family and maybe buy a few things online, now Facebook is talking about being an even bigger part of your life across multiple platforms. And I think that's the key, the multiple platforms. When I think of Google, which is sort of my favorite out of all these digital internet-based stocks, Google, their advantage is the multiple platforms, right? It's Gmail, it's Google Search, it's YouTube. Facebook is recreating their own sort of ecosystem of places that you connect to, mostly on the social world, but there's definitely a game to be had there because Google's never cracked the social world, and despite numerous attempts. So I think what you're seeing with Facebook now is really just a social media empire that is trying to dig more and more into everyday life and the power of your phone to connect with people. And when you're in a situation like that, competition is almost doesn't become a concern because you could literally just go buy who's ever out there. So I know that there's a lot of stuff out there with, you know, TikTok and Snapchat and whatever the next flavor of the day is. Facebook can pretty much stay back, watch these things grow, determine if they have an extended shelf life, and they can make a play on any of those companies out there, and they can wheel them back in to their own social media ecosystem and continue to build value for shareholders. All right, so at the end of the day, the question is Facebook stock a buy in 2020? My opinion is absolutely for sure. I would even try to take advantage of this recent dip, see where things stand maybe after a day or two if it keeps going down, but I don't think it's going to go down much beyond $200. So if you ever see it at $199 or less, I say definitely jump in, assuming there hasn't been any ridiculous news out there. It's just they have so much going for them for the future, and unlike many growth stocks that you have to bet on will they continue growing. Facebook's growing and they have profitability and they don't have any long-term debt. So those kind of three check marks by themselves from a risk scenario make them a very attractive play. All right, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a like and subscribe if you can. Really appreciate your support. We'll see you on the next video.